augment, serpentine substitute, that's the water down the oil pen, and the tissues and a lot of oil pens. 1-inch decorator brush, nylon fibers, and some filbert brushes, my favorite. So, although I'm using a 2-inch brush here, I've just been loosely looking at the reference, mixing in the white. This is very watered down oil paint, very, very watery. It's almost like an ink. So I've just been to create some atmosphere. I usually bend the paint in an angle. I don't just paint in straight lines. Or I find it works to be more atmospheric, to bend the brush strokes in extreme angles. So I'm looking at this reference, and I want my land to come up here. I'm just drawing it rough, very, very rough, and across to there. I've got a crown here. That's where roughly where I want my land to be. I want more sky in the land. I think to get an atmosphere, you need more sky and a sense of space. In some cases, it's best to get extreme white, pure white in the center, and work outwards. And try and keep that trimal blend out too much. Long strokes. You don't have to be precious about it, because you're just building it up with layers. It does get a bit messy, depending on your brush stroke. But I want this to create a bit more extreme atmosphere. See that almost rolling cloud there, the sky, right up at the corners. Take it down and around. It almost crisscross as well. So I'll always step back, take a look at your picture, see where you're going with it, so you know where you're going to go. Just to get it a good composition, you always have to step back and read that. I think I need a bit more tips. And this is the first painting of the series of six Northumberland. And this is the reference I'm using is a photograph of Simonside in Northumberland. Beautiful place, beautiful scenery. Maybe a bit too much turf, but doesn't matter. It's a studio. Be as messy as you want. Francis. Baker Studio. Have a look at his. So whiskey clouds as well. I can see in this photograph, I think. I'm just touching them, not pressing them hard and heavy. Just light. You've got to put energy in. You've got to use your body and legs. I've worked on a larger scale than this, 5 foot by 5 foot. And you've got to be like, you know, putting a lot of action in it. But with this, it's not too bad. Obviously, it's not as big. See a little bit more light coming down here. And the angles. I'm just changing the angles. I've kept that extreme dramatic atmosphere. And again, you can put it in the land as well. I can still see where I want this crack to be. So I can change brushes. And I can just draw in my line, loosely based on the crag. So I can see. Doesn't matter if you get runs. It always adds to it, you know, you can thin it out, you need to dry. And I'm taking that all the way down there. With a sense of climbing a hill. And I can see the path, the hillsides, leading up to the hillside of the car. So I'll draw that in there just as a reference point. And then I'll take another step back and have a look. Might be a bit too busy. You can always paint that out. And that's the beauty of tips. Thins oil paint right down. I think there's too much going on. Paint it out. Well, I'm sort of liking this dark bit here in the extreme there. You don't want to overdo it so that it reads well. So that's where I'm up to with the first painting in series 6. And we'll be developing this further. Thanks for watching. See you later.